What's up, Sud Squad? Joanna here, the soap gal. Today we are going to talk about a hot topic, soap curing. What is curing? Curing is what you do with your soap after the saponification has happened. So you have soap. So when you make your soap batter, you have your base oils and you have your lye and you put it all together and you stir it and you put in your additives and you make the most beautiful bar of soap. Now that bar has to sit 48 hours. Saponification, the process of those base oils becoming a solid and becoming soap, a salt. So curing is allowing that. You cut it and now you have to remove the additional liquid from that bar, allow it to dissipate, and you have to allow the rest of those soap crystals, because it's about 97-98% solid as a bar of soap. After the 48 hours and saponification is done, the bar is solid and you can cut the bar. Now it's time to do the R&D. How do you do the R&D to know how long it's going to take for the extra moisture to leave your bar? You put the bar on a scale, you record that number, and you continually do that through days or weeks until you get that same number consistently. Once you get that same number consistently, then you know that bar is cured and it would be a good bar to sell. And also another thing you can do is once you're weighing that bar, work with two bars. So then that way you have one bar that you're testing the weight, but you also have another bar testing the feel of it, and then test it in your shower. How long does it take for that soap to dissolve? Then you know what to tell your customer. But the time that it takes for you to get that number consistently, that really depends on your environment and your formula. You could use a water discount. A water discount is you're not using the full amount of water in that soap. You have less workability time, but when you're making daily use bars that's one or two color, you don't need a lot of time to be able to create that artistic bar. So you do a water discount, that way the soap can dissipate faster because there's not as much water in that bar. Also, you can be in a drier environment, like Arizona. Because I'm in a drier environment, again, the water dissipates from my bar faster. Now, talking about the soap crystals, yes, it does take a little bit longer for the soap crystals to become perfect, but 98% great. That bar still lathers, still is a good bar. I personally don't put my soap underneath a microscope to know when the soap crystals is perfect. That just takes time, and that just has to deal with R&D and you trying your soap and seeing what feel you want your bar to be. I'm on a Zoom call with, I think, the chemist of all chemists, at least in the soap world, Caveman Dunn.
I had had a student do a year-long honors project with me. I had him take a picture of soap under the microscope every 5 minutes for 4 hours. And then he stitched those together into a video so you could see a time-lapse video of soap, oil and lye mixed together as quick as he could get it up into a microscope slide. And you could see the soap crystals forming during that process. It was a very cool project. And then we were done. What I did for this project was I watched it for 8 weeks. I photographed it every day for 8 weeks. And I watched what happened to the soap crystals. The soap crystals were visible, but from one frame to the next, it went You could see it. You could see the soap shrinking under the microscope, and that was actually quite cool. But that's not news, because all they did was shrink. They didn't change size, they didn't change shape, they didn't change orientation. All they did was get shorter in the microscope slide as the soap dried up. That's 8 weeks of my life I'll never get back. Then I didn't do any more polarized light microscopy for a while. I went on to other things. And then I started to write this next book, which has a whole chapter about this race for the cure and polarized white microscopy and everything. Then I noticed that I had never moved that slide. After the 8 weeks, it just stayed on the microscope. So I was able, I only photographed it every day for 8 weeks, but then I was able to photograph it a year later.
Wow.
While it had dried out and shrunk a little bit more, the size and the shape and the orientations of the crystals hadn't changed in a year. All of my evidence to date is that during the curing process, soap dries out, it loses weight, and it gets harder. And as far as I can tell, that's all that's going on during the curing process.
One of the most important parts of being a soap maker is doing the research and development. My research and development is I'm in Arizona. I do a steep water discount. I know when I cut my bars of soap and I put them on the trays that I have pallets of soap that needs to be inspected. Once it becomes inspected and that whole lot is complete, it's then moved to pack. They pack those bars, then from pack to a case box, and then it goes onto a pallet, and then it waits in my warehouse until the consumer, my customer, decides to pick up that pallet of soap. And then that pallet goes onto a truck, and then it goes to a fulfillment center somewhere in the US. I don't know when the end consumer is going to receive that bar of soap, but I do know that that bar of soap has been in my warehouse personally for about 2 weeks before that soap gets onto a truck. So I know by the time it gets to the fulfillment center, my bar has been cured for 3 weeks. By the time it gets to the end consumer, I know that bar has been cured for 4 weeks. So I know that that is my process. Now it's your turn to find out what your process is going to be. Thank you for watching this video, and please remember to subscribe. And if you have any questions about curing your soap, please put them down below. I want to answer those questions. Remember, lather, rinse, profit, repeat.